using network-attached storage or NAS devices in Stratocast. A NAS, or network-attached storage device, is a physical storage unit that is connected to the network using a dedicated IP address and is used to record video on the edge of the network. You can use a NAS to expand the storage capacity of your local network and safely store and share video recorded from the units on your Stratocast system. NAS devices are optimized for file sharing and storage, are operating system independent, and are not the same as typical network servers. We recommend having a dedicated NAS for use with Stratocast, where no other device is accessing the storage space on the unit. Following this best practice, you'll get more accurate storage estimates and will not risk losing any files that are not related to Stratocast in case a format is required. There are several benefits to using a NAS device with Stratocast. NAS devices are easy to set up and maintain. Once the device has been installed on the network, you'll just need to create the volumes to be used within Stratocast, add them to the client's device list, and assign them to IP video cameras. Using NAS devices allows you to store all video from your units in one location on your network and makes file sharing very easy. Since NAS devices are optimized file storage systems, you will not need a centralized recording server or other expensive network video recorders. Using NAS devices also makes the system more flexible in terms of future expansion. If more storage space is required on your Stratocast system, additional NAS devices can be added as needed. Please note that each single NAS device has a limit of 16 IP video cameras that may record to it. The storage space on a NAS volume is divided up into sections or volumes, and Stratocast uses these volumes for video unit recording. A volume is considered a logical storage device that works independently of other volumes on the same NAS device. One volume can be assigned to only one IP video camera in Stratocast. Once the NAS device has been configured on the network, and the physical storage devices on the unit have been set up and formatted, we can set up our volumes on the unit. We will also need to set up shared folders on these volumes before they can be used with Stratocast. The NAS device used must support multiple volumes per device, not just multiple shared folders per volume. When deciding how much space to assign to a volume, please consider the size of the video files per day to be written there and how many days you wish to retain the video files. For more information on storage space calculations, please see the Additional Resources section of the online help for a helpful formula to use. After the volumes have been set up on the device, we can add them to Stratocast and then assign them to IP cameras. When creating the volumes on the device and in Stratocast, we can set up a username and password and assign specific user permissions. This allows more control over who can access the video files on the NAS device. There are a few important factors to keep in mind when we're using NAS volumes in Stratocast. When defining a NAS volume in Stratocast, we're specifying the IP address or host name of the device, as well as the shared folder name. The shared folder name must be unique to enable proper identification of the volume within Stratocast. Please note that a NAS volume can store a maximum of 2 terabytes of video files. To avoid any conflicts when making changes to cameras using the same NAS volume, the video unit and NAS volume in use will be locked. All other cameras will have a state of locked updating associated devices, and the NAS volume will have a state of locked updating associated cameras.